Torin! Now where is he? Torin, when are you gonna grow up? You pick up those tools from town like I told you?
I thought I'd do that tomorrow.
No, I need them in the morning. You get into town right now.
Yes, sir.
Hurry home, Torin. Don't be late for dinner.
Okay, Mom. This isn't what I want in life. I should be a hero. Heroes don't run errands. Right, Boogle? Hey, Boogle. Boogle! Asleep again? Ah, Boogle. Is this all my life will ever be? Running errands to this little town? I just don't want to live my life without ever having lived my life. They never hurt anyone! What happened?
I saw it. I saw everything.
Who are you? What are you doing here?
I was just passing by when all that started. I was so scared, I hid behind your barn.
Who could have done this?
It must have been one powerful sorcerer. Or sorceress.
Why? And who around here has such power?
No one I know. But once there was such a person. But no, Licentia's been gone for years.
Licentia? Who's Licentia?
Oh, I don't think it could possibly be her. She was banished to the lands below years ago.
The lands below? She must have been evil to be sent there.
Yes. And there's no way you could ever find her down there.
I know what I'll do. I'll find this Licentia and force her to release my parents.
I'm sure you will.
These berries look ripe. I wish I had a pleaver for every time I've swung this.
Hey, Boogle, let's go.
That's where Dad always sat after dinner and drifted off to sleep. I might need this empty pouch for something. That was Mom's favorite chair. I hope she's okay.
Hey, you! Come back here! Gotcha! Ow! Yep, the stove's still hot, all right.
Whoa, these spines are razor sharp. I'd better be careful. If you want a square meal, this looks like the route. In case of emergency, break glass. What could that mean?
Hello? Anybody home? Guess not. There's just no way I could break this off. Nice blue color, eh, Boogle?
Yeah, what's that? You rang?
Huh? Who are you? Where'd you come from? What are you doing there? You trying to sneak by me? Oh, I wasn't asleep, no sir. I heard you come through.
Well, I wasn't trying to sneak by you. I'm Torin, and I really need to get to the lands below. Can you help me?
The lands below? You're one of them? Well, you can't stay up here. You go right back down where you came from. Yep, nobody from down there gets past me, and you won't neither.
Oh, no, you misunderstand. I'm not from the lands below. I want to go there. So you do know how to get there?
Go there? Why, no one goes there. That's no place for any self-respecting citizen. Why, them worlds is filled with nutsos, malcontents, psychos, politicians. No, there's no way I'd let you go down there.
So you do know. Oh, please help me, sir. I must get to the lands below. May I come inside?
Nope, no way. Nobody gets inside this guardhouse except my replacement. Don't know where he is either. Was supposed to be here 10, maybe 12 years ago. Never been this late before. No, you gotta go. Get out of here and don't come back.
Halt! Who goes there?
It's me. I'm your replacement.
What? You are? Finally, it's about time. You must be 10 years late. Where have you been?
Heavy traffic.
Huh? Well, whatever. Hurry up and get inside here. I'm powerful hungry.
Okay.
Can't say I much care for the new uniforms. So, get started.
Okay. Started what?
Don't they teach you young'uns anything at basic anymore?
Well, maybe, but I wasn't exactly at the top of my class, you know?
I can see that. Don't tradition mean nothing no more? What's your generation coming to? Say, where's your provisions?
Provisions? Well,
My meal, boy. My meal. You know the core tradition. Before taking over, the replacement guard always cooks the departing guard his final meal.
I knew that. That's still taught to all of us. What is it you'd like exactly?
You mean you didn't bring it with you? Well, you won't find no home fort comforts out here. It's your problem, not mine. I know what I want.
Exactly what do you want for your last meal?
Last meal? I ain't dead yet. Hey, who are you? What are you doing in here? You my replacement?
Oh, brother, why, yes, I am your replacement. You know, there's a tradition that the new guard prepares the departing guard's meal, so I'm gonna fix yours.
Dang right I know, and I know what I want. Hope you brought it with you.
What'll you have?
For my appetizer, I want juice. Berry juice. Freshly squeezed, none of that canned crap either.
Berry juice, huh? Here you are, Herman. I brought you some berries.
Great. Now squeeze them.
What? Oh, all right. Where's the juicer?
I told you, over there, on the cabinet.
Boogle, can you be an axe? Here you go. Say, what kind of berries are those?
Why, chuck berries, of course. Ah, that tastes great. But now I'm getting a little hungry.
Oh, brother.
You know what I really miss?
I'm kind of afraid to hear.
Slaghetti and peatballs.
Slaghetti and peatballs? Don't you mean spaghetti and meatballs?
Ain't never heard of no such thing as that. Say, you sure you're from around here, boy? No. Slaghetti and peatballs is exactly what I crave.
Oh, okay. I'll fix it for you. What's in it?
Why, slugs and peat moss. What do you think?
I'll be sure to round up just enough for one meal.
What exactly do you want me to bring you?
Peat moss. Slugs. What are you, doll? Say, did I ever tell you the story about the last person I sent down?
No, you didn't. Yes. Yes, you did. So don't, okay? I'm in a bit of a hurry, you see, so.
Sweet young thing. Dang shame. They clamped that collar round her neck so tight she couldn't hardly breathe. And then, poof, she was gone. Couldn't ever come back home. Too bad.
Huh. Fascinating. Bye.
Thank you.
this works. Got it. Oh, shoot.
If I could only reach that branch.
You'd be better off worrying about getting off that rope than reaching for your bag.
Now, how am I gonna get my bag? Boogle, stop!
What?
Boogle? You mean this whole time you could have walked right out on that bog? Only when it's funny, huh? I'll only when it's funny you.
What are you looking at?
Yeah, you got nothing better to do? Staring at snails?
Well, no, actually. Wait, hey, I have a lot to do. But who are you?
Who are we? Who in the Tenebris are you?
Yeah, who are you?
I'm Torin. Torin Farman.
Farmhand? Yeah, you look like a farmhand.
Farmhand. Good one, Slim.
Thanks, Slime. High five!
All right!
Slim and Slime, you guys seem different from the others I've met around here.
Different? You bet we're different.
Yeah, what do you think? You're talking to just another couple of snails?
Yeah, you're quite a pair.
Why, that's right. We are a pair.
A pair! Good one, Slim.
Thanks, Slime. High five!
All right!
Say, guys, could you help me with those slugs over there on the next tree? I can't even get close to them. How can I trap them?
Trap them? Yeah, you could. If you had bait.
And we know just what they like, don't we, Slime?
Sure do, Slim. But we can't tell you, Torin Farmhand.
Why not? I'm honest, trustworthy, sincere.
Oh, it's not that.
Nah, it's because you haven't done anything for us yet.
What could I do for you?
Help us turn over a new leaf.
Turn over a new leaf. Good one, Slim.
Thanks, Slime. High five.
All right.
While I'm not totally unfamiliar with 12-step programs...
That's not what I meant by turn over a new leaf.
What he meant was, we need a new leaf to practice our pair's figure sliming.
Yeah, a big leaf.
A really big leaf.
You know, something with style.
Class.
Chlorophyll.
Retsin.
Something to give us that competitive edge.
Something that will put us over the top, slime-wise.
Yeah, you got anything like that?
Why am I taking a leaf?
81 quarps. Too little. 19 tuppets. 20 squids. Too little. Stop! That's it! That's the biggest leaf of all!
Oh, nice call. Thanks, Inchy.
That's Mr. Worm to you.
Hey, come back here. Now, which one is it? Oh, not again. Gotcha. Oops. Ooh, yuck. Hey, Boogle, get that, will ya? I found it, boys. This is the biggest leaf in all the woods.
You?
You did?
You brought us a leaf?
Yep, and here it is. Now, tell me about those slugs. How can I capture them?
Ooh, nice texture.
Nice structure.
Good size.
Professional markings.
Okay, it's a deal.
Yep, done deal.
You want a i5?
No, thanks. No.
Your loss. Okay, here you go.
Slugs love scum.
Yeah, pond scum is good.
Nah, you can have your pond scum. Bog scum, now that's the best.
Bog scum? No, definitely moat scum. That's what you want.
Ooh, yeah. Moat scum is choice.
Too bad you can't get it.
What do you mean, can't get it? I know where the moat is.
Yeah, you know where, but do you know what's?
Like, what's in that moat?
Oh, yeah, croctopus, and lots of them.
Wouldn't lots of them be croctopi?
Croctopi, croctopuses, don't matter. You'll never get close enough to the water to get scum from the moat.
Wait a minute. Didn't you say you were going to the Moat Olympics?
Yeah, why?
Well, if I took you over there, would you help me get some moat scum?
Slim, what do you think?
Okay by me. Better than crawling.
Okay, big boy, let's go moatin'.
Here, hop on your leaf.
Thank you.
There's no way I could get across that moat.
Here we are, boys, the site of the next Moat Olympics. I hope you win the gold medal.
Thanks, Torin. You're okay for such a dry person.
Yeah, thanks. And in return, I'll put in a good word for you with some of my croctopus friends.
Good word? I don't need good words. I need moat scum, and plenty of it.
Oh, you do, do you?
And exactly where do you want it?
Why, right up here.
Hey, Croc, pass the boy some scum.
Well, I guess I'll just leave this delicious moat scum right here for a while.
Now I'm gonna get you. Those slugs are so fast, I'll never catch them like this. If only I could make a trap.
Boogle, can you make a box right over that moat scum?
I'm not jumping up there again. I might slip and fall on that scum.
That's it, Boog. Now we've got him. No more caffeine for you guys. Thanks, Boogle. Here's your order, sir. Slugs and peat moss, just as you requested. But boy, did I have to go through a lot just to bring these to you.
Yeah, I'm sure. You probably just walked around that cliff to the deli.
What? You mean...
Just a little guardhouse humor, boy. Ain't no food within days of this place. Now get over there in that kitchen and rattle them pots and pans.
All right. But this is my first attempt at cooking such a delicacy. Well, at least it's quick to prepare.
Here you are, monsieur. Bon appétit.
Now, can we get on with it?
Now, the perfect conclusion to a near-perfect meal.
Dessert. And an iced latte.
Dessert? Latte? Oh, no.
Oh, stop your griping. You can skip the latte. Just bring me some dessert.
Huh. All right. What'll you have for dessert?
Why, there's only one thing that'd top slaghetti and peatballs.
I'm afraid to ask.
Root?
Yeah, let's make sure of something. If I prepare you a root, then will I be done?
Bingo! Bright boy. Yep, good old root'd be just fine.
Here you go. One large root. Want to help me fix it?
No, I'll just wait right here.
Somehow I guessed as much.
Say, nice square shape, too. Them's the best kind.
Okay, how about if I make it into a pie?
Great! While that's in the oven baking, why don't you and I head back to the phenocryst chamber? Ah, just smell that aroma. You know, there's nothing like coming home to find the square root pie.
Phew! Say, we going out on that joke?
No, we're going out through the secret passage. Wait here while I get something. Pick a shard. Any shard. I've been waiting 15 years to use that line. There you go, boy. The joint's all yours. I'm gonna grab my pie and hit the road. Gotta get on home, you know. That is, if I can remember where home is.
But wait, what about me? Aren't you supposed to train me in how this thing works?
Works? Can't. Don't remember. Heck, it don't matter no way, boy. Nobody's come through here in years.
But is this the way to the lands below?
Could be. But you don't care. All you gotta do is make sure nobody from down there gets up here.
That podium must be important to this huge crystal, or it wouldn't be protected by those giant stones.
This powder must be important, but what if there isn't any of it in the lands below? I'd better find something to hold enough so I can get home again. I'd better get enough of this powder to last. If it does take me to the lands below, I'll need enough to get home again.
Back in the bag, buddy. Hang on, Boogle. I hope I'm right about this.
Sir, they were both in there.
And?
They're gone.
And the child. missing.
The child must be found immediately.
Oh, not again.
Live on City ROM from beautiful Cliffside Escarpa, it's the Bitternuts! With Jack Blackman as Mr. Bitternut. And starring Sandra Bullhockey as Mrs. Bitternut. With Vinyl McCulkin as Little Bobby Bitternut. Today, we join the Bitternuts just as they hear a knock on their door.
Just a minute! Holly, can you get that? Oh, never mind. Do I have to do everything around here? Coming! Yo! Aren't you the giant economy-sized visitor? You know I'd ask you in, but I'm not sure there's enough air in here. Holly, take a look at this guy. This is what a real man looks like. Holly? Oh, honey, don't mind him. He's just acting his IQ. you want to come in? Or maybe that should be, can you come in?
Why, thank you. I will.
Hey, Mom, I... Hey, Mom, I... Whoa! Who's the big guy?
We don't know, honey. We're still waiting to find out.
My name is Torin, from the lands above.
I'm Mrs. Bitternut, and this is what's left of my husband, Mr. Bitternut. And that's Bobby, our son. what's that thing in your purse?
Why, that's my little buddy, Boogle. Oh, he won't hurt you. He likes people.
Yeah?
Then he won't fit in here. If he's smart, he'll stay off my furniture.
Mrs. Bitternut, I was wondering...
Selfish. That's all they are. Lived right across the chasm for years. Do we ever hear from them?
I'm sorry, what?
Oh, that King Rupert. He really fries my cornbread. Lives almost next door. Does he ever invite us over? No! Why, you'd think he was better than us or something.
I'm sure King Rupert means to be nice to you. Perhaps he's just busy.
Busy for 20 years? And that queen of his.
Die?
Yeah, she should.
Why? What's wrong with her?
Too snooty for me, that's what, Torin. Why, she acts like they didn't have a daughter that was... Hey, have you met their daughter?
What about their daughter?
Her name's Lena, or something like that. You two should get together, Torin. You have so much in common.
We do? Like what?
Your looks, I suppose.
Yeah, you two deserve each other.
How would you describe Lena?
Well, let's see. She has a nice personality. She's kind to her parents, I suppose. She's a good climber. She's lots of fun. She's a good dancer. She's got a great personality.
In other words, she's a lot like you.
How would you describe Lena?
Well, let's see. She's...
In other words...
How do you do, sir? My name is Torin.
Leave him alone. He ain't spoke to nobody in years.
Yes, I can see why.
Hey, what are you doing? Put that down.
Hello, young man.
Did he touch you, boy?
Not really, Mom.
What do you mean, not really? You touch that boy again, I'll have you arrested. We don't need no uppity strangers from some other land touching our kids.
Hey, Boogle, let's go. Be sure to join us next time when we hear Bobby Bitternut ask.
I don't know how that stain got there, Mom.
The Bitternut is not filmed before a live audience.
the bag, bub.
Well, well, what have we here? It's nice to see humility in somebody around here.
Good day, sir.
Yes, it is, isn't it? But then every day is a good day here in paradise.
A land as lovely as this should be called paradise.
Maybe it should, but we call it a scop. But the real question is, what do we call you?
Oh, forgive me, sir. My name is Torin of the lands above.
I am Rupert, King of Escarpa, and this is my lovely wife, Queen Di.
Oh, how do you do, ma'am?
Alarmed, I'm sure.
Eh? What's that?
I said, charmed, I'm sure.
That's nice.
King Rupert, Queen Di, I am here seeking Licentia, an evil sorceress who may be in this area. Have you heard of her?
I haven't heard of any Licentia.
He hasn't heard of anything he can remember.
What's that, my queen?
I said, if you'd heard a thing, you'd have her dismembered.
Yes, that's true. She's not here in Escarpa, young man. Perhaps she's in some other world below us, but you are welcome to stay here as my guest for as long as you wish.
Thank you, Your Majesty. Do you know how to get to the worlds below Escarpa?
It seems I recall a connection back when I was a young boy, but lately we've seen no one at all from the other worlds. I don't know why. I suppose we've just lost touch.
You can say that again.
Eh? I missed that, Di.
I say, that's a sin.
Well, yes, I suppose. I didn't realize you felt so strongly about foreign affairs.
If you only knew.
I cannot stay long in Escarpa. I must find Licentia.
Yes, I understand. But in your travels, if you happen upon a young lady named Lena, would you give her a message?
Of course, but how will I know her? What does she look like?
Lena is, very tall. Yes, nearly as tall as you.
And nearly as unsightly.
Excuse me?
I said she should call home nightly.
Oh.
Is it back then forth, or forth then back?
I love the artwork over your throne, Your Majesty.
Why, thank you. But somehow I've always felt my shard collection was incomplete.
As incomplete as your memory, you specious fool.
What's that you say, darling?
I said, no art can compete with our memories, my precious jewel.
Oh, yes, quite so, quite so. What do you think, boy? Isn't she something?
Yes, that she is. Is Lena from Escarpa?
Of course. She is my daughter.
Oh, really? A princess? Has she been gone long?
Only a few days, but parents worry nonetheless.
I understand. I know what it's like to miss a loved one.
Di, my dear, why don't you give this boy a piece of your jewelry? That way Lena will know he represents us.
Oh, brother, are you right in his pocket?
What was that?
I said, tell her mother sent her this locket.
Oh, yes. Good idea.
Here, Torin. Take this one. See? It has a picture of Rupert and me on the inside.
I promise to keep it safe until I find her. Your Majesty, I can see you are a lover of crystals.
Yes, that's the only kind he is.
What did you say?
I said, yes, and how kind he is.
Why, thank you, dear. But continue, boy.
I humbly offer you this gift from the lands above. I think it will balance your set of crystal shards. May I?
Yes, of course.
There. And as this one simple shard completes the connection between the formerly distinct spectra above us, so too, therefore, may our two worlds be connected by the peace and understanding that comes from, you know, it, like that, there. Oh.
Here, here!
Bravo.
I say, what the devil was the boy talking about, Di?
Beats me.
Di, what did you say?
I said, beats me.
Well, I'll consider it. Why, thank you, Torin. It's perfect. And in return, I'd like to present you with this invitation to next week's royal ball.
Nice swap. Shard for free tickets, you cheapskate.
What? What did you say, Di?
I said, I hope he's still free at this late date.
Oh. Yes, boy, do attend.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
I hope this isn't one of those buffets with an eat-all-you-take policy.
Your Majesty, this tile seems similar to others I've seen around Escarpa.
Yes, I suppose it is. It was a most popular style a few years ago.
May I have it for my collection?
But what for?
Oh, nothing, I guess. I just kind of liked it.
No, not without a very good reason, young man.
We now return you to the Bitternuts, already in progress.
Just a minute! Coming! Do I have to do everything around here?
How would you describe Lena? Mrs. B, I just came from King Rupert, and he asked me to give you this.
What is it?
An invitation to the royal ball.
We're going to the ball. Ain't you excited? Oh, he's never been excited in his life. Torin, if there's anything we own that you need for your journey, why, just help yourself. It's yours.
Why, thank you, Mrs. B.
Of course, I'd love it if you'd take the mister over there. Hey, hey, what are you doing? Put that down. That's my best trivet.
Oh, Mom, let him have it. You haven't cooked since I was born.
The kid's right. Go on, take it. But don't go taking anything else, you hear? And good luck on your quest, young man. Hey, any chance of you taking Junior along with you?
None whatsoever, I'm afraid. But thanks for the trivet, Mrs. B. In the bag, bub.
Be sure to join us next time when we hear Bobby Bitternut ask.
I don't know how that stain got there, Mom.
The Bitternuts is not filmed before a live audience.
I've got it! Hey, you! What a stench! I wonder what's inside there. Boogle, can you be a worm? Check back inside there. I bet it's a way out of this land. Yeah, I bet it's dark in there. What are we gonna do? Boogle, turn into a lantern so we can see what's back there. Wow, Boogle. It looks brown and soft and smells terrible. We've just got to have some of that. Say, Boogle, would you mind being a shovel? I say, be a shovel. Okay, Boogle, turn back into a worm again and get out of there. But don't forget our sample.
Hello, my name is Torin.
Hey, get out of here!
Oh, Tripe, you're such a grump. Hello, young man.
Hello, may I walk past?
But of course.
No, this is our ledge. Why don't you just jump off?
Tripe? Oh, just ignore him. He's just a grumpy old stick in the bowels.
Don't talk to him, Viserba. He must be up to no good. I don't like him. Besides that, he's ugly.
Ugly? Well.
Yeah, you're ugly. You're skinny and tall. Why, I've only seen one person tall as you.
Tripe, stop it. Come to think of it, young man, you do remind me of someone hereabouts. Someone special, too. Royalty. She'd be quite a catch for someone that looks like, someone of your, appearance.
She? Oh, really? But, I'm not in the habit of taking dating advice from a vulture. On the other hand, I would like to get past you so I could head up those steps. Would you mind if I asked you to move from your nest?
Mind? Of course not.
Thank you.
Don't mind, cause I ain't gonna.
Now, Tripe, we could go for a little flight. I know my wing gajuri is a stretch.
Nope. My wing is fine. Not moving. Happy right here.
I hereby order you to fly away.
And I order you to shut up. And, perchance, did I forget to mention? Go away!
There's just no reasoning with him when he's in one of his moods.
Yeah, and I'm always in one.
How strange. That ramp juts out even farther than the vulture's nest below it.
Hey, vulture! Try and catch this!
Hey, Viscera, look at that! Fresh dead meat, flying! Hey, let's go after it!
As always, I'm with you.
Can't you hurry up a little? It's getting away from us.
For goodness sake, for once in your life, can't you just stop and smell the rotting meat?
What's that beside that little tree?
Oh, I think we can make it, Boog. Hang on, Boog. I hope this is worth it. This ladder looks a little rickety, but I'm going to try it anyway.
You've discovered the fast way to get to the lands below.
Someone left this clothespin just hanging here.
Hello?
She's so busy washing, she never even noticed me. Just don't look down.
Boogle? Is that you? No, wait. I think it's coming from up ahead. Uh-oh, Boog. Skunks ahead. Skunks, are you there?
I'm here. Are you, Max?
I'm here too, Sam. And why do you ask?
Oh, well, I was, just wondering. Could I pass through your cave?
Well, you could try. Yeah, come on. It's been a while since our last target practice.
Yeah, there's a chance, sweet miss.
Boog, I've got it. I'll just put this clothespin on my nose. Then I won't be able to smell the skunks. Hang on, Boogle. We're going in.
Greetings, sir.
Funny, he looks awake.
Greetings, sir.
I could have sworn he squirmed just a little then.
Greetings, sir.
What? Who are you? And why are you here?
I'm Torin. Who are you?
That's what I'm trying to determine.
I mean, what's your name?
Name? Vida. Is this why you come here? To torment me with unimportant questions? Where are the real questions? The ones aching deep inside you? Who are you? What do you believe? What do you know?
Actually, I haven't really gotten to those questions yet. My question is more simple.
Simpler?
Huh? Whatever. I'm trying to find a sorceress named Licentia. Could you help me?
Forget her! I know the girl you should meet. Sweet girl. Good to her parents. Clever conversationalist. She has a nice personality.
Uh-oh.
I think not. See, I'm only here for a short stay. I need to find Licentia. Remember her? I asked you about her a few seconds ago.
Never heard of her.
Do you know how to get to the lands below?
Do you know how to help the area below?
What? I don't understand.
You'd understand if it was you sitting on this stone tile all day and all night. The parts below, the bottom line, the rear guard.
Here's a thick, soft cushion I think you'll like.
Let me feel. Ah, fine materials. Nice padding. Soft cover. Firm, yet breathable. I thank you very much, O tall, slender one. And in return, why don't you take this instrument of my torture? Just drop it over a cliff someplace if you don't want it, okay?
Oh, I would never do that.
What?
There's just no way I could climb down there without falling. This ought to drive those women out of there.
She is such a witch. Did I tell you about the new perfume?
Yes. Now that the girls are gone, let's send you down there as a yo-yo, Boogle. Boogle! Grab that tile hanging there! Attaboy, Boog! Boogle, see where that doorway goes. Hey, Boogle, let's go.
That tree grow. This should either make that tree grow or kill it completely.
You mentioned a message for Lena, Your Majesty.
Why, yes. Tell her to come home. We all miss her greatly.
At least one of us.
Eh? What's that you say, Di?
I said every last one of us.
Oh. Well, yes, that's right. So tell her that, my boy, if you happen upon her, that is.
I will. Your Majesty, I think this tile is part of something important.
You're right. It's part of my floor.
No. Even more than that. You see, at the base of the opposite cliff, I've found an unusual room containing a large formation that would hold this tile perfectly. I feel certain that the formation is something important. Perhaps it even holds access to the lands below.
Why then, of course you may take it.
Thank you, Your Highness.
The sacred chamber that lies ahead contains an ancient phenocryst column. For centuries, travelers have journeyed throughout the planet of Strata by means of these columns. Connecting the world within worlds, phenocrysts are able to transmit far more than mere light. Through the use of Arisky powder discovered by Tor the First in the early Unity period, people now have instant mobility. So step inside and enjoy the latest in phenocryst travel.
Thank you. Before I pass judgment, have you anything to say?
The child. Is he safe?
Far away, where he will come to no harm. Although we suspect your involvement in the murder of our beloved royal couple, we could not find enough evidence to convict you. But since you were clearly guilty of kidnapping the crown prince, you are hereby sentenced to spend the rest of your life in the lands below. I therefore order an ostracizing collar be fabricated for you and placed around your neck, never to be removed. And should you ever attempt to return to the lands above, the collar will tighten until it chokes you to death.
Is this place? Wow, but it is beautiful.
After the Pergolins tie you securely to the ground, they bring by all their friends to stare at you. You do not harm them, mainly because you're a skeleton.
Stop that! Let me go! Get away! Shoo! Wait! Don't be afraid. Hold still. There.
On behalf of all Pergolins everywhere, I would like to thank you, Giant, for saving the life of Fairmont.
Oh, that's all right.
Ow! Hey, no, quit! No, that's too loud! My ears.
Stop, Olivia! Hey, knock it off!
Oh, sorry!
Okay.
You seem to be a kinder, gentler giant, not like some giants we know. I wonder if you could help us with a problem.
But of course. You need some logs moved, rocks realigned?
Villages trampled?
Much worse. We recently captured another giant, but very different from you. This one will not cooperate at all.
What can I do?
Perhaps if you talked with it.
Well, okay. But are you sure I'll be safe?
Follow me.
No!
It's okay. I won't hurt you.
No! No!
It's all right. I'm not going to hurt you.
Huh. You're with them, aren't you? Get away from me.
But I want to free you.
Get away. You'll only hurt me more.
Won't you let me help you?
Help me? Like they did? Ha! Huh. Show some respect. Just leave me here to die.
Oh, I could never do that. You're far too beautiful for me to leave you here.
Flattery won't help. Go away, so help me. If you do figure out a way to release me, I'll scratch your eyes out.
Hey, you're Lena, aren't you? I just came from your homeland. I met your mother and father.
You did? Escarpa? My parents? Oh, how I wish I had listened to them. I wouldn't be in this mess.
They told me to give you this.
What is this? Some sort of cruel joke? Is this trinket supposed to fool me? What are the Pergolins trying to pull? And to think for a moment there I started to trust you.
What? No. I mean, Queen Di said to give it to you.
Huh. Like I'm going to believe that. You could have found this bauble anywhere. Oh, look. That is my dear, sweet father and I. Oh, how I miss them. Maybe you are from Escarpa, but you're so tall. Who are you, anyway?
My name is Torin, but I'm not from Escarpa. I'm from the lands above.
Torin of the lands above. Do you promise not to harm me?
I swear. At present, I can think of nothing worse.
All right then, quick, cut me loose.
Well,
Hurry, before they stop you.
Yeah, I can't. I'll have to try to break each little thread, I suppose.
Why? Use your knife.
Well, that's just it. I didn't bring a knife. Some hero I am. Well, hold still. Here goes.
Then, I'll tell you a little secret. All this time, I've had a knife hidden in my boot, but they tied me up before I regained consciousness.
Now, hold still. I wouldn't want to cut you.
Oh, thank you, Torin. That was horrible.
Here. Here's your locket. Oh, Boogle. Here, let me help you up.
Oh, wait. Look at your arms. You're bleeding.
What? Oh, I'm okay. I dropped a long ways through the trees before I landed on this soft loam. I must have, caught some branches on the way down. It's nothing.
Nonsense. Come over here. I'm sure I heard a stream this way.
Everyone in Escarpa said we should meet, but I never dared dream we really would.
Everyone else was so short and hairy. I was always the ugly duckling. Too tall, too thin, hair only on top. But with you, I feel, I don't know, somehow normal.
Oh, I think you're anything but normal.
What? Torin!
Huh? No, what I meant was you're far above normal. You're beautiful, wonderful, perfect.
Oh, Torin. But my parents must be worried sick.
Well, yeah, they are. They really want you to return home. And my parents, they're still in danger.
I must go on.
You're right. But will I see you again?
You must.
Excuse me, you two. Will you be staying for dinner? If so, I'd better send out several hunting parties.
No, we've got to leave immediately. We have to begin our search for a phenocryst.
Oh, no need. I know right where one is, but it's pretty far away.
What? I can't believe it. Does it work?
Well, it might. You see, it hasn't been used in some time.
Somehow, I could have guessed that. Let's go, Lena.
Attention, everyone. This is Torin and his friend Lena. Please give him your attention. They're all yours.
But what do I do?
Well, that's the problem. No one knows. The phenocryst hasn't been used in generations. Legend has it that when the ostiaries find perfect harmony, the worlds will open unto them. But even when wearing these ancient sacred robes, they cannot find the way themselves. Can you help them?
Oh, boy. Okay, you step into the center. And you, take his place. Hurry, Lena! Jump up here! That's it. The pattern was 5 ascending notes leading to the second nested planet. So that phenocryst goes back to a scarpa.
Uh.
Oh, Torin, I knew you could do it.
You did?
But now what?
Oh, this part I know. Stand over here. I'll throw enough of this powder for both of us, and off we'll go.
Don't forget me, Torin.
I couldn't, Lena.
Be careful. This Licentia sounds dangerous.
I will. Now, close your eyes.
They are closed. Save enough powder for a trip to Escarpa.
I promise. I'll see you soon, Lena. Somehow.
Goodbye, Torin. And goodbye, Boogle.
I always felt you were innocent. Kurtzwell needed a scapegoat. All these years away from your home, your family, your friends, you must be so bitter.
Perhaps. I've learned to use the darkness to get what I want.
I've heard you've become quite the powerful sorceress.
Oh?
But not quite powerful enough to overcome the magic of that collar.
Not yet. But perhaps soon. And when I do, I promise revenge.
But what if you could return sooner?
What? Ha! The collar will not be denied.
I could release it for you.
Oh, Peccant. You know its spell can only be broken by royalty. And no matter how much you scheme, you'll never be king as long as the boy lives.
Yes, but think, Lysandra. Who sealed the collar?
Kurtzwell. That... Wait. Are you suggesting you could become Arch Authority?
Let's just say if you'll do a small favor for me, I'll do a large favor for you.
And just what would that small favor be?
Nothing much, just a little magic spell.
Is that writing? It's so dirty, I just can't tell.
Ooh, smells like ammonia.
Welcome to Asthenia. Huh.
What?
That must be where the people lived who defended this island. To see a military-industrial complex with a sense of humor. Of course, maybe that's why there's no one left around here.
Cannonballs? Man, these suckers are heavy. Hey, Boogle, let's go. Good idea, but you overshot your mark. Bag, bub.
In this area, you can only walk in straight lines to prevent you from falling in the lava. If lava lies between you and where you click, you'll only walk to the edge of that lava. A series of short movements works best. In this area, you can... In this area, you can... In this area, you can...
This looks like a valve, but I can't turn it with my bare hands. Yes. What this does.
Oh, good. It's blocked. Let me guess. Another console.
He's about to reach Tenebris. I'm sure there's no way he'll ever find you, but I just thought you'd want to know.
You old fool! No complications, you said. Simple, you said. I should have known. All right. I'll take care of it. He won't find me or his parents. Now, what about the rest of our bargain?
In time, my dear, all in due time.
Dreep! I have someone I'd like you to find.
How can I help? Meet up, Dublin.
Thanks, Boog. Hey, how did you do that? Hurry, Boog. Hop in.
Get that. Thank you.
Google, save us! Save us! I said save us, Boogle!
All right, you'd better come with me. You're under arrest.
But, officer, what for?
Cruelty to plants. Just leave your friend here. If he's lucky, you'll be back in a few years.
Where's Mom and Dad? Will I ever find them? And Boogle, I hope he's okay.
Boogle, is that you? Boogle, no!
Come on, boy. It's time.
Do you have anything to say before I pass judgment, young man?
Well, no, sir. Not really. It's just that, well, I'm really sorry I landed in your plants. It was an accident. I only landed in that flower bed because I fell out of that air duct that I crawled through to escape from that storeroom that I materialized in from that phoenicris that I used to get here from Asthenia.
Phoenicris, you say?
Yes, sir.
I haven't heard of one of those being used in years. Where did you say you were from, son?
From the lands above, sir. See, this evil sorceress put my parents in a magic spell and kidnapped them, and this old guy saw it all, and he said her name was Licentia, and she's from down here, and that's where my parents are, so I set out to find her and, you know, save them, but nobody has ever heard of her, and well, I don't even know if she's down here or if this has all been some kind of... And, geez, do you think you could help me, sir?
Licentia, eh? There's no one on this planet by that name. But whether you're a visitor here or not, you need to learn three lessons about Tenebrous and me. First, plants are very scarce around here, and we are not kind to those who damage them. Second, lawbreakers in my court are handled immediately and forcefully. And third, one more mistake and I'll toss you right off this planet into the null void. Now take him back where you found him. And young man, I don't ever want to see you here again.
Excuse me?
Yes? Oh, it's you.
Could you help me?
Help you? I doubt it. After what you and your safe-like buddy did to my friends over there.
But I didn't mean to hurt you. I didn't know plants could hurt. In fact, I didn't know plants could talk.
Well, not all can. Just exceptional plants, you see.
Sure, I thought you looked special.
Well, yes, I... what is it you need, young man?
I've searched this entire planet looking for an evil sorceress named Licentia. Have you heard of her?
Animal, vegetable, or mineral?
Huh? Animal, I suppose.
Doesn't matter, never heard of her. But that doesn't mean she doesn't live around here. I don't get out much. Roots, you know.
Is there anyone here in Tenebris that could help me?
Well, let's see. You know, there is that strange duck who's always recording Oddchrists.
Oh, a duck? What's his name? Where could I find him?
No, he's not a real duck. Don't remember his name. Don't know that I ever heard it. But he might be down at the amphitheater. He hangs out there recording talent.
Thank you so much. Now, which way is the amphitheater?
Oh, you can't get there from here.
But this theater, which way is it?
It's over the slippery slope. You'll never make it. Without a little help, that is.
Help? Oh, could you? I'd be eternally grateful.
No, you won't. That's just a cliché. But if we could work out a deal...
Anything. Just name it.
See my friends down there? Those pesky chameleon silkworms are wreaking havoc on their leaves.
Now who's the cliché?
What? Oh, anyway, if you can stop the silkworms, I'll convince the grass to help you cross the slippery slope.
So, it's silkworms I seek?
Yes, Mr. Short-Term Memory Loss. Clear out those worms, and I'll help you get where you're going.
So...
Here's a dead, long-stemmed flower on this dauber plant. Surely no one would mind me pruning this.
Hey, come back here. Hey, come back.
This tree's trunk is covered with some very sticky stuff.
Hey, stop poking me.
Hey, you can speak. Although, I don't know why I'm surprised.
Of course I can, but what good does it do me? No one listens.
You sound discouraged.
Not so much discouraged, but sometimes I do get a little sentimental.
Oh, I think all of us do sometimes.
Yes, but when you're as well-rooted as I, somehow old memories just stick to you.
I see. Well, not to go out on a limb, but why not branch out into new activities?
Well, you know, I can't just leave. But I'm stuck here with a trunkload of memories. What brings you here, just looking for someone to bark at?
I'm searching for my parents. I think they were captured by Licentia, a sorceress I was told came from around here. Could you help me? Have you heard of her?
You lost your parents? Oh, me too! I was transplanted at birth. You know, my dad was cut down in his prime of life by a guy chasing a wolf. And Mom, she fell in the forest and nobody heard it!
Gee, I'm sorry.
Oh, that's all right. I told you I'm just a little sentimental sap. Look at me. I'm a mess.
Well, you are rather drippy. Excuse me, do you mind if I borrow a little of this sap?
No, not at all. Go ahead. Use me. Everyone does. I just hope that somehow, someday, someone, somewhere will find some way to make something out of us trees. And then they can cut us all down. What if someone invents telephone poles?
Gotcha. I did it! The silkworms are no longer a problem. But aren't they kind of funny colored?
Oh, those little buggers produce silk of any hue. Just place them on a color and they'll make a copy of it for you. And in silk yet. But don't waste them. And please, don't drop them around here, okay?
I did it! The silkworms are no longer a problem. But aren't they kind of...
Now that I've rescued your friends, will you help me cross?
Okay! Nope. No. Not here. Nope. No. No way! No. 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 No way! Nope.
Listen carefully, but click cautiously.
No! Nay! No! Yay! Not here! No way! No! Yes! Yes! Not here! Yes! No! Not here! No way! No way!
Thank you. Thank you very much. Oops.
That's it. I'm out of here. If anyone needs me, I'll be in my trailer.
Hold still. It's tough enough aiming between the two of you. Oops.
That's it! I have had it! I quit!
Quit? Who said that?
I can't take this anymore, you know? There's gotta be a better gig than this. I'm out of here!
Why, you ungrateful! You can't quit! You're fired! And I quit! I should have never fired his 15 sisters.
Hi there.
What a fool I've been.
You seem unhappy.
He almost killed me! I'm never gonna work for him again!
I'm looking for an evil sorceress named Licentia. Have you seen her?
He nearly killed me!
Does she live around here?
Not to mention twice yesterday!
So, is that a no?
He was lucky to have somebody like me!
You're not really paying attention to me, are you?
Somebody with quick reflexes!
Should I leave?
His body count would even have been higher!
Well, nice talking at you.
Boy, he's a jerk!
Hey, Bags, take a look at this.
Say, nice twins.
Yeah, and look inside.
Whoa! Is that real silk?
I think so. It feels real to me.
You mind if I try it on?
No, not at all.
Oh, I love it. Oh, it's me. Oh, it's definitely me. What do you think?
Huh? Oh, yes. It's you. It's very you.
Oh, look. It's got a secret compartment, too. Ooh.
It seems complete.
Room enough for a pool. Ooh. Practice my breaststroke. I'll take it.
Excuse me, are you a magician?
Who? Where? Oh, me. Yes. Actually, I am a magician. Well, no. I'm not just any magician. As of yesterday morning, I'm Zippy the Magnificent. And who are you?
I'm Torin of the Lands Above.
Well, Torin, would you like to see a trick?
Well, actually, I was going to ask you some questions.
Splendid. All right, here. Take this deck of cards. Cut it anywhere. Memorize the card. Got it? Good. Now hold the deck tightly between your two hands. Tighter. Don't let go. Remember your card?
Yes.
Now, if I could make your card appear from my sleeve, in spite of the fact that you're still holding that selfsame card in your very own hands, would you be impressed?
Yeah, I guess.
Well, all I have to do is say the magic words, Ally McGraw, and presto! Here's your card.
That's not my card. That's a bouquet of flowers.
Oops. I knew that. Here, watch me make that disappear. All right, now let's see. Where was I? Oh, yes. If I could make your card appear from my sleeve, in spite of the fact that you're holding hands with that very same card, would you be impressed?
Yeah, I guess.
And here it is, right here.
No, that's not my card either.
Well, what did you have? A heart?
No, that's not even a card. That's a bird.
Oh, so it is. Get out of here! Oh, do I need a better act? Okay, is this your card?
No, that's a book.
Well, I don't know where your card is. Maybe it's still there in your hands.
You know, at this point, I don't really care.
All right, then. Give me back my cards. You can keep your lousy two of diamonds.
Hey, that's right. That was my card.
Well, it's too late now to sweet-talk me. If only I had one good trick.
You want to try that card trick again?
No, I've had it with that trick. I'm just going to stand here until I come up with something spectacular. Or something great. Well, at least something not bad.
You'll never guess what I got for you, Zippy.
You're right. Put it down so I can feel it.
It's a real top hat with a rabbit inside. You know, like in a real magic trick.
Let me see. Yes, but who's this?
It's me, Zippy. Biggs. Biggs Bunny. You remember me, don't you?
Yes. I thought you said you'd never work for me.
Well, that was before you offered me this fine silk-like top hat to live in. Man, what a hat like this. Even you should be able to do magic.
Hey, are you going to start this relationship off on a sour note?
Or step inside and I'll do the tricks.
Silly rabbit. Tricks are for magicians.
Grab your wand and let's practice.
That is a problem. I seem to have lost my magic wand.
Oh, no problem. Ask this Torin guy here to find it. What did it look like? Oops. Sorry.
Now are you ready to try your new trick, Zippy?
What do you think, Bags? Can you do it without a magic wand?
I can. Can you?
Well, probably not. I could really use a magic wand, Torin.
Where am I going to find a magic wand around here?
I don't know. Perhaps you could make one.
Shh! I'm recording.
Oh, I'm sorry. Is this better?
No, not really. Let me hit pause here. There. Now, what was it you were saying?
I'm Torin, and I'm seeking...
No use to whisper now, young man.
Oh, well, anyway, I'm Torin, and I'm trying to locate an evil sorceress named Licentia.
Licentia, eh? Oh, sure, I know her.
You do? Oh, I've asked darn near everybody on this planet, and you're the only one.
I'm probably one of the few who does know her. My hobby is recording rare voices, and hers is one of the rarest.
Then you know where I could find her?
Oh, you wouldn't want to. When I met her, I found her quite rude.
Rude? She's more than rude. She's unscrupulous, ruthless, unconscionable, immoral, unethical, unprincipled. She's...
Whoa, calm down. It doesn't matter. You can't get to her anyway.
What do you mean, can't get to her? You don't know how far I've come already. Why, I've survived capture in the jungle, vicious vultures, stinking skunks, lava, snails, slugs, you name it. Of course I'll get to her.
Very impressive. What is that accent? You see, young man, Lysentia was expelled from our world many years ago. Tossed into the null void she was, and never heard from again.
The null void? I've got to go after her.
That will be a problem. The void is so dangerous. All the entrances to it were sealed long ago.
You said you record voices. Have you recorded hers?
Why, yes, I have. It's one of my rarest treasures.
I'd love to have it.
Oh no, to someone like me, there's nothing more valuable than a rare voice.
Oh really? What if you had a voice rarer than Lysentia's?
What? Why, I don't think that's possible.
Oh yeah? Do you have any recordings from the lands above?
Of course not. The last time those savages visited us, this Oddcrist technology was not even developed.
I am one of those savages.
What? You? Is it possible? That accent, it's subtle, but... I thought I detected something unusual in your voice.
What do you say? Trade a recording of Lysentia for a recording of a voice you may never hear again?
Well, a deal.
Okay, what do you want me to say?
Anything. Let me set up a clean crystal here. There, ready when you are.
Test. Is this on? Hello? My name is Torin, from the Farman Valley. Near Crystal City, in the lands above. I've traveled through Escarpa, Pergola, and Esthenia to get to Tenebris for only one reason. To find the evil sorceress Lysentia, force her to free my parents and my friend Boogle, and in the process, teach her a lesson.
That's enough. It's only a 10-meg crystal. Great. Now, let me find that Oddcrist with her voice. And here, I'll even throw in this old Christ quarter so you can play it back.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome, and good luck finding Lysentia. Now, if you'll pardon me, I have work to do.
Excuse me.
Just wait your turn. I'll call you when I'm ready for you. You can warm up anywhere, but just do it quietly. I've got people on stage already.
Warm up? Did you say warm up? It's not really that cold in here.
I'm laughing. What's your name?
Torin. But I don't have an act.
Neither do the rest of these clowns.
I'm looking for Lysentia the Sorceress. Have you heard of her?
Nah, but she might be scheduled later. I got Zippy the Blind Magician coming up soon. Would he do?
Pardon me, ma'am.
Look, I don't care about your problems. I don't care if you got stage fright. I don't care if you need makeup. I'm real busy. I got your name right here on my list. Torin, Special Sawist. I'll summon you when it's time to go on.
Special Sauce?
You don't understand.
Actually, you don't understand. I'm in charge here. I call you when I want you. You don't speak to me unless you're spoken to. You got it? You got it. Now, get away.
Look, I know you don't want to be bothered.
But you're gonna bother me anyway, right? Why don't you just go off in a corner someplace and practice your saw? I'll call you when I'm good and ready.
You mean you want me to go on stage here?
You weren't exactly the pick of the litter, were ya? Yes! You! And your saw! On the stage! Rub, bow, back and forth! Jeez!
Excuse me.
Yeah?
I'm looking for a sorceress.
I ain't her.
I'm sorry to bother you, but do you know Licentia?
No, you didn't.
Huh?
You didn't send me. The Union Hall sent me.
No. Licentia. She's a sorceress from around here, I think.
I never heard of her. Who are you? You're that new musical saw play everybody's been raving about.
Musical saw? You can use a saw to make music?
Well, sometimes I make this one here sing a little.
Have you seen this saw player?
No, the only saw I saw is this saw I saw with.
I think we all saw that one coming.
Have you seen this saw player?
No, the only...
I think we all...
Excuse me, are there any sorceresses around?
Swabwicket, Wizwakwing, sauce.
Did he say something about sauce?
Excuse me, are there any sorceresses around?
Swabwicket, Wizwakwing, sauce.
Did he say something?
Now are you ready to try your new trick, Zippy?
What do you think, Bags? Can you do it without a magic wand?
I can!
Well, probably not.
Where am I going to find a magic wand around?
I don't know.
Look, I know you don't want to be bothered.
But you're gonna bother?
You mean...
You weren't exactly the pick of the...
By the time he reached pubescence, he could outshoot all the...
Oh, darn.
Here you go, Zippy. I found your wand.
Oh, thank you, Torin. Say, this isn't my wand. What are you trying to pull here?
Nothing. I thought you needed a wand.
I do. But remember, I'm blind, not stupid.
Well, what's the difference? Wand, schmand. Are you a magician or ain't you?
You're right. Thank you, Torin. This will do just fine.
So what are you waiting for? Pull a fancy colored silk over me and let's get rolling!
Well now, that's another problem.
What now?
I don't have a silk.
A magician without a silk kerchief? Torin!
Yes, Torin.
I made this beautiful silk as a gift for you, Zippy.
Why, thank you. It feels lovely. So smooth. I just don't know what I'll do with it. Perhaps stuff it in my breast pocket. I don't know.
I was thinking you might use it to cover the rabbit inside your top hat.
That's good, too.
So, what are we waiting for? Show us a trick.
Here, Zippy. It's showtime. Pull that fancy silk over me.
All right, I will. Thanks to you, Torin. You know, you've been so nice to me. Would you like this book of magic spells? It should get you past any sorcerers you find in these parts. Besides, I don't read that much anymore.
Thanks, Zippy, and good luck with your act.
You're not welcome here, you decrepit old creep. You're not welcome here, you decrepit old creep. You're not welcome here, you decrepit old creep. You're not welcome here, you decrepit old...
Mr. Torin,
and now, a medley of my favorite songs from the lands above. Where the peat moss croons in the light of three full moons, and those crystal mountains summon my heart home. Yes, the lands above are the place I'll always love. No matter through how many worlds I roam.
That's it. Now come with me.
But officer, why, you have tears in your eyes. Are you from the lands above too?
No, I'm a musician. Now come with me. You're under arrest.
What for?
Impersonating a singer.
Torin of the lands above, since you violated the probationary period I granted you, I have no choice but to sentence you to immediate ostracization from the world of Tenebrous. Into the null void with him.
Not the null void.
Exactly where I want to go.
Here we are, boy. Now you stand over there.
Hey!
Good riddance, plant crusher.
How can I just float in midair like this? Oh, I get it. In the very center of the planet, gravity pulls equally from all directions. But how can I move? There's nothing to grab onto.
Ok,
Congratulations, you did it. That's nice to see someone else has an Al Lowe sense of humor. That's why you get to hear this, my very own personal Easter egg, instead of the boring, plain old death message you see before you there on the screen. Anybody who comes all the way through this game asking everybody you meet about this evil sorceress named Licentia and then finally finds her and then tricks Dreep into following a recording of her voice and then doesn't use the Book of Magic on her but instead plays the bagpipes deserves much more than just another boring old death message. So here's my personal thank you for playing the game. And now, enjoy the ending. But whatever you do, don't tell anybody how you got this message. Instead, just taunt them with, "Why, I got a personal message from Al Lowe at the end. Didn't you?"
What? You dare enter my home and attempt your little magic spells on me? Foolish boy, I have more power in my little finger than you'll ever possess. The collar. Torin. Of course. Who else could remove the collar?
How do you know my name?
I was your nanny.
Nanny?
I saved your life the night your parents were murdered.
Murdered? No! How could you? I thought you had them in a magic spell.
No, Torin. The Farmans are safe. But they're not your real parents. Your real parents were the king and queen of the lands above.
What? But then I'm...
That's right. You're the next king.
No, that's wrong. I'm the next king.
You should have died in your cradle that night, little nephew. After searching for you all these years, you won't escape me now. I killed your parents. And now I'll kill you. One step closer, boy, and I'll finish her.
No, don't! Licentia! Licentia, are you okay? That was close. I thought he had you there for a second. Hey, Licentia! But the lava...
That's not lava. That's Dreep's supper dish.
What about my parents and Boogle?
Of course. Torin, I think it's time for all of us to go back home, to the lands above.
Where's my tools? From town, remember?
Son, who's this lady?
And is she gonna stay for dinner?
Mom! Dad! Oh, it's great to be home again. Oh.
Thank you.